Hey guys, welcome back to the brand new video. In this video, we're gonna create a minimal looking slideshow animation, which is super easy to create in Adobe After Effects without using any third-party plugins. So this is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's open Adobe After Effects and get started. Alright, so this is Adobe After Effects, and let's start by creating a new composition. It's very simple, just click on this new composition button, or you can just go over here and take a new composition. And this is gonna be our main composition, so I'm gonna call it main. Set the size of this composition 1920 by 1080, frame rate 60, duration make it 6 seconds long, background color black, hit OK. Now we have to create a white background for this animation, so just go to layer, go to new and take a new solid layer. I'm gonna call it busy for background. Select a pure white color from here. And now let's create one more composition, that is gonna be our media placeholder, where we can drag and drop our image or video file. So what we have to do, just go to composition, take a new composition. I'm gonna call it media. Leave the setting as it is, hit OK. And now we have to import any image or video file for this animation. So it's very simple. Just go to project window, right click on that, go to import file and select any image. So in this case, I'm using this image that I have downloaded from unsplash.com, and I will give you a link in the description. So you can download this free image from unsplash.com. Once you have downloaded and select the image, just click on import. And now we have to fit the image inside of this media composition. So it's very simple. And then just go to your main composition. Here we have to import the media composition inside of the main composition, just like that. And then we have to animate the media composition. So just go to the end of this animation at 6 seconds, hit S to bring out the scale property, turn on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the scale property. Just go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the scale value 125%. And now we have this type of slow zoom out effect, which is looking absolutely perfect. And now we have to apply one more effect on this media composition. Just go to effect and preset and search for brightness and contrast. So I'm gonna adjust the contrast of the image. This is the contrast. Let's set the contrast value 25 or 30. It's looking much more better, as you can see. You can adjust this value according to your image or video file. And now you can close the media composition. After that, we have to create animated shapes to animate the image. So what we have to do, just go to composition, take a new composition. This time I'm gonna call it animated shape. Here we have the lock aspect ratio option. So we have to uncheck this option and set the width value something around 4500. Leave the other setting as it is, hit OK. And now we have to create a rectangle shape. So here we have the rectangle tool. Let's select this rounded rectangle tool, click on fill button, set it to solid color, hit OK. Select a light color, maybe pure white because we have a dark background. Click on stroke, set it to none, hit OK. And now let's create this type of rectangular shape. Open the rectangle one, open the rectangle path one, and here we have the size. We have to set the width and height individually. So just unlink width and height by clicking on this button, and this is the width and this is the height. So I'm gonna set the width value 1200, height value 300, roundness something around 200. Now we have to align the anchor point in the center of the shape. So this is the move tool, select the move tool, select the shape layer, hold control on the keyboard, just double click on this span behind tool to set the anchor point in the center. Now let's align the shape in the center. So select the move tool, go to align. If you don't have this window, just go to window and check this option align. Click on the align horizontally and vertically, set it in the center. Now you can close the shape layer. After that, we have to create two more copy of this shape layer. So hit control D two times, and now we have three different copy. Select the second copy, hold shift on the keyboard, press right arrow key and move this shape on the right hand side, just like that. Select the third one, hold shift and press left arrow key and move the shape on the left hand side, just like that. And then select all the layers, right click on that, click on pre-compose, and this is the layer one. So I'm gonna call it L1. Check this option, move all attributes into the new composition, hit OK. After that, we have to create two more copies of this layer. So hit Ctrl D two times on the keyboard and rename it properly. Select the second layer, hold Shift on the keyboard, press up arrow key and move this shape just like that. Press right arrow key and set it like this. Do the same thing for third one, hold Shift on the keyboard, press down arrow key and set it like this. Now you can hold Ctrl on the keyboard and scroll it up to zoom in, and you can adjust these gaps just like that. And then you can click on fit button, and after that we have to animate the shape. Just go to the end of this animation, select the second and third layer, hit P on the keyboard to open the position property. Click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the position property at the end of this animation. Just go to very first frame of this animation. Now let's move the shape. So select the second one, hold Shift on the keyboard, press left arrow key and set it on the left hand side. Select the third one, hold Shift and press right arrow key and set it on the right hand side, just like that. And we will get this type of animation. After that, select all the keyframes. Hit F9 to easy ease them, or you can also right click on the keyframe, go to keyframe assistant and click on easy ease. And then just select these keyframe, go to graph editor, and here we have this type of graph editor. If you don't have this type of graph editor, then right click on this graph editor and check this option, edit a speed graph. And then we have to set the CDI at the center of this animation, just like that. Highlight this point, hold this handle and place the handle right over here. And do the same thing for this one. Highlight this point, hold this handle and set it like this. So we have this type of interesting animation. Perfect. And then you can close the graph editor, close the layer, and after that select all the layers again, right click on that, click on pre-compose, and I'm gonna call it shapes. Check this option and hit OK. Just go to 2 seconds, hit P again to open the position property of this shape composition. Click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe and lock the position as it is. Just go to very first frame of this animation, hold Shift on the keyboard, press left arrow key and move the shape on the left hand side, just like that. And then just go to 4 seconds, lock the position of this shape as it is. So click on the diamond button and lock the value. And then just go to the end of this animation, hold Shift on the keyboard, press right arrow key and move all the shapes on the right hand side, just like that. And then select all the keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease them, go to your graph editor, and here highlight this point, hold this handle and move it on the left hand side and set it like this. Highlight this point, hold this handle and move it on the right hand side. And now we have nice and smooth animation in as well as the animation out. Alright, and now you can close the graph editor and go to the main composition. Here we have to import the animated shapes, so just go to project window and this is the animated shape. Let's import the animated shape into the main composition. After that, just select the media and go to track mat. If you don't have the track mat, then click on the toggle switches and this is the track mat. Just go to track mat and select this option, animated shape. Now we will get this type of effect as you can see. After that, select the shape animation, hit R to bring out the rotation property. Set the rotation -45°. You can set this value according to you. Hit S to bring out your scale and let's scale it up a little bit. I'm going to set the value 125%, and then let's set the shape right over here. And finally, we have something like this. And now let's fit the image inside of this animated shape perfectly. So what we have to do, select the media composition and move the image and set it according to you. And then we have to fill this blank area. So what we have to do, just go to the effect and preset and search for motion tile. So this is the motion tile effect. Let's apply the motion tile on the media composition. Here we have the output width. So I'm going to set the output width 150 or 200, whatever you like. And then we have to check this option, mirror edges. And now it is looking absolutely perfect, as you can see. After that, we have to create animated text. So it's very simple again. Just close all the layers, select the text tool, go to character and select your favorite font style first. So in this case, I'm using this Babus New Pro font style, which is an Adobe font style. I'm going to set the style regular, set the size of the font something around 500 pixel. Click over here and type a number. So this is the first slide. So I'm going to type a number 01. I'm going to align the text on the right hand side. So just go to paragraph and click on this option, right align text. All right, because I have to place this text on the right hand side. Just select the move tool and set the text right over here. And then just go to effect and preset and search for fill effect. Let's apply the fill effect on this text layer. And here we have to pick a color from the image. So in this case, I'm using this color. It's looking perfect. And then we have to animate the text. So what we have to do, just go to 1.5 second, hit T to bring out the opacity of this text layer. Click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the opacity. Just go to very first frame of this animation, set the opacity 0, and maybe just go to 1.5 second on this keyframe. And I'm going to set the opacity 15% and do the same thing at the end of this animation. So just go to 4.5 second. Click on this diamond button to lock the opacity value as it is. Just go to the end of this animation, set the opacity 0%. And now we have something like this. And finally, we have to create our main text. So just select the text tool again. Go to character, select the Babus New Pro. I'm going to set the font size 100 pixel and select the style book. Click over here and type your text. Just like that. Select the bottom line and increase the size of the text. I'm going to set the value 120 pixel and change the style of the text, maybe irregular. Select the move tool and place the text right over here. Just like that. And again, we have to align the text on the right hand side. So just go to paragraph and click on this option. And now let's animate the text. So open the text. Here we have the animate. Click on the animate, select the parameter opacity, click on the add, go to property and select the position as well. And now we have the position and opacity inside of the animator one. I'm going to set the position something around 150, opacity 0. Open the range selector and this is the start. Let's animate the start. Just go to 2 seconds and click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the start property and set the start value 100. Just go to very first frame of this animation, set the start value 0. And then just go to 4 seconds, click on the diamond button to create a keyframe on the start property. And then just go to the end of this animation. Again, we have to set the start value 0. Just open the advance and this is the based on character. So I'm going to change this to line or word. I'm going to select this option line. Now you can close the text layer and then select the text layer, hit U to bring out the active keyframes, select all the keyframes, hit F9 on the keyboard to easy erase them, go to your graph editor and here just go to the center of these two keyframes at 1 second, highlight this point, hold this handle and just move it like this and create this type of graph right over here, just like that, and repeat the same process for this one. Perfect. And now you can close the graph editor and here we have this type of text animation as you can see. And now you can close this text layer and it's almost done. So just click on the toggle switches and turn on the motion blur for all the layers. Just go to very first frame of this animation, go to full screen and let's have a look. Alright, so it's looking awesome and that's all for this video. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos and also hit the like button for this video. My name is Vikas and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.